हेलो।
हाँ हेलो।
हाँ
हाँ, वो स्टार्ट वेरी सुन। ओके, गुड
अच्छा,
मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम एवरीवन इन द सेकेंड डे ऑफ आवर ऑनलाइन स्पेशल लेक्चर सीरीज। वी विल स्टार्ट आवर सेशन। टुडे वी आर हैविंग टू सेशंस। इन आवर फर्स्ट सेशन, श्री हेमंत कुमार, हु इज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश विद्याशागर यूनिवर्सिटी मेदिनीपुर, विल डिलीवर और रादर से ही विल इंट्रोड्यूस अस द टर्म मॉडर्निज्म एंड इट्स कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड सेवरल अदर थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू मॉडर्निज्म। हेमंत is my friend and we had spent a great deal amount of time together while doing our PhD in Pondicherry University, and he has already submitted his thesis and waiting for his public viva to be conducted. He's a well-knowledge scholar and I will not waste time to listen to him. So it's over to you, sir. And let's listen to Sri Hemant Kumar.
Thank you for inviting me. Since I actually wanted to talk about Joyce, but since Joyce is not in the syllabus, I thought I'll give a basic introduction of modernism or modernisms, rather. Because modern is not a monolithic term or a monolithic movement as such. Right? So modernism is an artistic movement. Modernism is an artistic movement, an avant-garde movement, which focused on formalist experimentation, which also was complex, which was elliptical. Elliptical is again derived from the term ellipsis. Ellipsis is usually symbolized with three dots. Ellipsis. Ellipsis basically refers to gaps in terms of knowledge, gaps in the text, in a modernist text. If you read a modern text, gaps that needs to be filled up by the reader himself. So modernism as an artistic movement was not a monolithic movement. That is why after the 1960s, for example, we don't talk about one overarching monument of modernism. We talk types of modernisms,